Okay, just a small comparison between compensators, lead compensator, lag compensator. So lead compensator improves the transient response, whereas lag compensator improves the steady state response. Lead compensator improves the transient response means it makes dynamic response faster. The transient will reach steady state as fast as possible, whereas there will be no change in the steady state. Okay. So means there will be, but significantly it will be very less change, okay, in comparison to dynamic response. So dynamic response will be way more faster. Then dynamic response will be slow, but steady state error will decrease here. So the way it improves the steady state response by reducing the steady state error. But dynamic response will become slow in this case. Here the steady state response will not change, the dynamic response will become faster. Okay, so depends upon the condition what you want, you use compensators. Then lead compensator increases the bandwidth. We have seen the magnitude versus frequency plot, so it is like this. So it's a high pass filter, you can say. So lead compensator, one minute, I'll check. Okay, so yeah, this behaves as a high pass filter, so HPF, and this behaves as a low pass filter because of this magnitude response. Its magnitude response is like this, and its magnitude response is like this. This is the two corner frequencies. So you can see this curve looks like a high pass filter. It is passing the high frequency component and it is passing the low pass frequency component and suppressing the high pass one. So that's how you can think high pass and low pass, and because of that it increases the bandwidth because of high pass filter and decreases the bandwidth because of low pass filter. Okay, so these are the comparison of lead and lag compensator I wanted to make, just a small comparison. Okay.